Okay, so part two of the castle flower beds. I had recorded more, but it cut off. So this is the poppy I left off with. And then over here, maybe there's a reason why it got cut off. I couldn't remember the name of this bush. It's an azalea. And this particular one is gonna put off white blooms with this sort of pink splashes of paint looking stuff on them. I did have another one right here, but it died. The middle of it died, so I just jerked it out. But these are not easy to grow in Oklahoma, at least I don't think so. I've tried before, finally realized that I needed to plant it in part sun. So hopefully this one will survive and put off some blooms. I think I see bloom coming right there. So anyway, it's lovely. Actually, look at all those blooms. This is gonna be good. Oh yeah, I love azalea bushes, and I hope that bush survives. So here it is from a distance, okay? I don't think I've been showing you things from a distance, how they look in perspective. By the way, I showed you this big fluffy white ball to be, but I didn't tell you what was gonna go there. I always put purple fountain grass there. That purple fountain grass will get about 3 feet high and 2 to 3 feet wide, and it puts off these furry little cattails at the top, and it sways in the wind. And I love grasses that sway in the wind, very peaceful. So anyway, and looking back at all the things that I showed you, I mean, just look at how that orange rocket barberry bush kind of glows in between those dark colors. And then from a distance over there, what I had shown you. So anyway, back over here, you saw the poppies and the peony bush. And right here, I'm gonna put another one of those fluorescent yellow ligustrom bushes that you see in the middle of this picture right here. See it way in the distance, kind of in front of the neighbor's truck? You can see it popping out. That's what's gonna go right there. It's gonna fill it up nicely, but it won't be too close to the peonies because again, I don't want those to get disease on them and bugs traveling from top to top. So it'll go right there. And then this is another beloved bush. It is the hot lips bush. Yes, it really is called the hot lips bush. And it will be hanging over that side. It will be hanging over the front. It will expand out to about right there. And it will get about as high as the top of this video. It's magnificent. And it will be covered with delicate little red and white little tiny blooms all over it. Very unique looking. So I will update this video probably in a month or two so you can see what everything looks like a bloom. But I love the hot lips bush. Right here, this little tree here with the boy and the girl below, that's a Rose of Sharon bush tree. And man, does it put off and proliferate in the blooms. And they are purple and white blooms. They're just absolutely gorgeous. The only negative thing I can say about this Rose of Sharon is that it is in close proximity to this phenomenal October Glory maple tree. This is the tree you're always seeing me taking videos and pictures of in the fall because it goes from green to yellow to orange to red to burgundy, and it is absolutely a tourism attraction in our neighborhood because it's so beautifully shaped and so on fire. Although I will say the last 2 years have been a disappointment. I don't know why, and I kind of wonder if it's because the spiders have just, they've decided they like it too. And they like to shoot their little silk from those tips down to the Rose of Sharon bush, making it a little scary to walk down this path in the evening and nighttime. Frankly, you just don't do it unless you have a big broom and you're jerking them down, and you might see 5 different webs just literally hanging right there. It's creepy, creepy, creepy. I wonder if I'm gonna have to jerk this tree out. I don't know, maybe this tree. Anyway, our latest project is this dwarf fountain grass. It will fill up a good portion of this little scallop. And again, it's that grass that has the little cattails at the top that sways in the wind, that's so peaceful. I just thought that would be really nice there. I used to have a big big, humongous, ugly bush here. One of those holly kind of bushes. But it was an attractant for snakes. Mm-hmm, big snakes. So we ripped that out and decided to put this in here. That'll fill up the space and it'll be really pretty. So, moving along quickly, I can't believe I didn't get the rest of this video. That it got cut off. These are all those violas that you saw in that little pot on each side of the stairway to the front porch. These are violas, otherwise known as Johnny Jump-Ups. They are so beautiful. I love their happy little faces. And anyway, I didn't know they could be perennials. They all of these that you see came back. They stayed all throughout the winter. I couldn't believe it. Took them all out, put more soil in because it was really low on soil, planted them all back, and wish me luck. I'm hoping these things will be even more beautiful than they were last year. There weren't near this many in this pot last year. That's how many grew in there. Anyway, over here. Since I don't do gardening anymore, vegetable gardening, because my hands hurt too much, I've got arthritis in my hands and it's just hard to dig and do all that work. So I decided to plant some vegetables in my flower garden. These are macho nacho jalapeno bushes. Okay, I love jalapenos. I love hot and spicy foods, even though my stomach doesn't. I don't know how much longer I'll be able to do it, but these are cannas back there. And at one time, a couple years ago, I thought about jerking them out because I thought they were dying off. I had like three different colors in here. I think they were orange, yellow, and white. And now I only have orange, which is fine because I get all this new growth that I did not expect. So they are expanding. I forget what the name of it is when they just keep growing back underneath the ground. It's like a network, a system. Those get about as tall as the top of the video. Love them. They're beautiful. There's my little froggy. These are pink sky petunias. Oh, they're so pretty. Last year I had these starry skies. They were purple with the white splash on them. This year I decided to do the pink. They're so pretty. And I think they're happy here. They've been here a week and a half and they still look pretty robust. And that's tick seed. I thought that was gonna die off too, but it didn't. And I thought it was gonna die because I would see spider webs on all the time. So this year I will be spraying a lot of insect and disease killer. And these will get about a foot tall and have little orange jagged edge daisies all over them. Don't know what this is called, but you can find it at Home Depot and Lowe's. It's kind of a plum color. And I absolutely love these burgundy plum colored stems. They're just gorgeous. That's a lot bigger this spring than it has been in the past. I love that. There's me and Steven. This is a dianthus. I'm pretty sure of it. I think it's also called, the nickname is a bachelor button. You'll have purple and white jagged edged blooms all over the top of this thing. You can see it's about ready to bloom in places. Oh, nope. Here's the bloom. Right there. Yeah, there you go. This is a winter creeper bush. I put it here because I needed something in the winter that stayed green. Otherwise, it's really bare looking. You can see all these shoots. It just, as the name suggests, creeps and creeps. It's so pretty. I just love the white edges on these things. I just love it. A lot of new growth this year. Lots. Not sure what these are called, but they get about a foot high and they've got purple tops to them. They're very popular in Oklahoma. The name escapes me right now. These are verbenas. With my girl reading. Yeah, love these things. They're kind of gangly. They get long instead of tall. It's kind of like a little ground cover. This one came back. That was a surprise. Maybe it shouldn't have been. This is another variation of tick seed. It'll get about 10 inches high. It's really pretty with yellow blooms. This is Mexican heather grass. I like this stuff. Again, it's that peaceful waving in the wind grass. Okay, I might even put another one over here where you're looking. Love this thing. Very peaceful, very gentle. And then these are asparagus ferns. These are gonna go in big pots up on my porch near the front door. The pots from last year, one of them broke. I'm just too cheap to go out and spend, you know, $60 to $80 on a really nice glazed colorful pot. It just seems ridiculous, but I'll break down and do it, I guess. really quick. Petunias. Thought that was a really pretty color. Doing very well so far. This is a Is this a chrysanthemum? Yes. No. This is not a This is a... Oh my goodness. This is... Okay. Getting old. Can't remember. This is Mexican lavender bush. Oh my goodness. I love this thing. And as you can see, it is getting ready to bloom these 1-inch tall purple blooms that will have these two little purple ears that stick out the top like this. And they sway in the wind. More swaying in the wind. Peacefulness. Oh, and they smell so, so fragrant. They're just a really beautiful bush. They attract butterflies like no other. Matter of fact, a butterfly just flew by. I used to have these in War Acres. Instead, they were bushes. They weren't like this patio tree variety that I stumbled upon the last year, the beginning of the spring. It's got a real nice woody, stocky base to it. I didn't think it would last through the winter. I thought it was just one of those things they sell in Oklahoma that you can enjoy for a summer and then it dies, but not so. These things are hardy. When I had them in War Acres, again, it was just a bush that was in the ground and it just grew and grew and grew and it got huge. And I mean, I would have a sea of butterflies on that thing. It was just amazing. Maybe I'll find the video and try and show you all, whoever's watching this, whoever is still with me and not bored to tears yet. Oh wait, here it is. Here's the name of this thing. I want to make sure I gave it to you right. Lavender patio tree. Okay. And the name still escapes me on this, but then again, we have the pink sky. Love it. And then we have, really quick here, we have pink Gerber daisies. And this one is a yellow. It's going to bloom pretty soon, I hope. But the trick is to get these things to stay with you all summer, because I have a feeling they don't really like the heat, even though they say they're okay with heat. And some more of the pink sky petunias. Aren't they gorgeous? I love these things. Okay, so there we go. Backyard, and I'm gonna